Bet you're eager to sign up a user to test this checkmark functionality. So am I. So what we'll do is just finish off the workflow for the personal details, then we'll go back to the signup page and then look at the workflow, the difference between signing up a company and a user. Little hint, signing up a user is far easier. Let's get stuck in. Okay, so everything is in place here really. So we have the company user's name first, name last, about, location. So we don't really need to change much. Let's have a look at the workflow. So let's click edit workflow. And on the save button, we're making changes to a user. Everything seems to be attached just fine. And then we're showing the message. Perfect. Let's head back to the signup page now. Actually, before we do that, one thing I did want to change that I've noticed on my little break there is if we bring back up the account, these buttons I want to change back to the brand color because we're not dealing with a company that has a particular brand color. So I want to use the particular workplace brand within the candidate dashboard. So I'm going to choose primary button there. Same with work preferences. There's no chance of clashing here because Canada doesn't upload a logo or anything like that. Okay, with that out the way, let's head over to the signup page because there's a new concept we're going to learn here called custom events. So click on the signup button and edit the workflow. And currently this workflow states that a user signs up and that the user type matches the user type. Great. But the problem with this button or this workflow is that it's going to be creating a company and it's going to set the company slug and it's going to go to the page company. And we don't want that, okay? So what we want to do is we want to retain the same button. We don't want to show and hide different buttons. Minimal, dry method, all right? Do not repeat yourself, nice and clean. Instead, we're going to use custom events and triggers to determine or split the workflow depending on if the user is a company or a candidate. So click on this little empty box here that says, click here to add an event. We're going to go down to custom and we're going to create a custom event. Okay, we're going to call this custom event company. And let's change the color here to blue. I tend to use blue for my custom events. Then we're going to create another one. This one is going to be called candidate. Change it to blue. Now let's go back to the signup button. Let's change it to green. And this is what I'd like to do. I'd like you to click on this arrow between step one and two, and then go down to custom events and choose trigger a custom event. Now Bubble is saying which custom event. So when a person clicks on button sign up, we're going to sign them up, and then we're going to actually push them into either this candidate or company custom event. And within each of those will be the unique workflows. So we'll have those workflows ready to go and we just route the user off to their respective custom event. So for the first one, for the company, okay, this will run, but we need an only when statement here. So we're going to say only when current users, because after signing up, they become a current user. Only when current users, user type, then choose is, not display, is, company. When that is true, then head over to the company custom events and we're going to move the workflows here. Go ahead, right click, copy and paste, right click, paste. And to step three, let's change the custom event to route through to the candidate custom event and change current users user type as company to candidate. Pretty cool. Now, let's move these workflows to the company. So I'm going to right-click Cut, click the custom event for company, and then right-click Paste. Okay, back to button sign up, make changes to a user, right-click Cut, company, right click, paste into step two. And now we've broken this expression, so I just want to reconnect the result of step one. Okay, so we're creating the company and then making changes to the current user, adding the company to the user. Setting slug needs to be moved to the company workflow. Right click, cut, and right click, paste. Again, thing to change is the result of step one, which is the creation of this company. Looking good, guys, looking good. And then right click again, cut, go to page company because that needs to belong to the custom event for company. Paste, and which data, which company are we sending to the company page? The result of step one with the V equals settings. Okay, so you're probably thinking, wow, this is awesome. So we can create all these custom events and then route people through all these different workflows depending on what type of user they are. And yes, that's what we can do. So these custom events are super, super powerful, and start to investigate and figure out how they can be used in other instances. They're super flexible. What about the candidate now? So let's have a look. So we're going to sign the user up. And we're doing the usual stuff, capturing the email, password, setting the type for user, and then we're going to send them off to the candidate custom event. And guys, there's nothing else we really need to do here aside from navigation, go to page, and now we can select our new candidate page we've just created. There's no need to send data because you're just referencing the current user. There's no page data, but we do need to set the view. So check the box to send more parameters to the page. Choose V equals account, all lowercase, or it won't work. So it's a really nice way to basically chop our workflows and neatly sort them into the respective consecutive steps that they need to be. So they're all together. All the company flows on this custom event, and the user flows are in this event. And in real life, with the applications that I've built, I've sometimes had three or four different types of users, and that would go to a custom event, and then that custom event would then trigger another custom event for a reusable piece of logic that I use in other parts of the app as well. So it's really exciting, the amount of power that Bubble gives us to be able to create these unique logic experiences. All right, guys. So let's go back to the design. A person clicks I'm a candidate. That should hide this now. So the company name, let's head over to the layout tab. And I'd like you to check that this input is not visible in page load and then it's collapsed when hidden. And we're only going to show it on condition that the state on the signup element, signup page, this user type is company. That's when it's visible. So if someone clicks on I'm a company, then we can see the input. If they click on I'm a candidate, that input will be hidden and collapsed. All right, guys, head over to your Scratchpad page, please, and just preview your Scratchpad page because I'd like to make sure that you're not logged in as anyone. Okay, I'm just going to click on the logout so it routes me to the correct page. And then I'm going to go to sign up, just checking my internal navigation. All right, so you can see that currently the company name input is hidden. If I click on that, it brings it back. If I click on I'm a candidate, it then removes it. Okay, guys, let's sign up as a user called Peter, basically. So just type peter@email.com. Please do, I'm going to refer to Peter in as his name, not as a candidate, just as Peter. So just follow along with this. So peter@email.com. Any password you like, it's still not clickable, so we're going to choose agree to the terms of service and sign up. Here we go. V equals account, and we can see what we need to see. Now you can go ahead and check these boxes. Have a look at that. Very cool. So yeah, so make some selections here, folks. Make some selections. Once you've done that, we're not actually going to use this for anything. It's just to teach you how to work within state lists. Go ahead and save, and then successfully saved. Let's get Peter's name in here. Peter's last name is Hudson. For the about, let's just type anything you like here. So I said, I'm looking for tech jobs in New York. I have a background in data science and AI. So let's say that his location is also New York then. And save. Fantastic. Last thing we need to do is upload Peter Hudson's image in your resources folder. And then let's just save one more time. Let's check out the database. So I've clicked on all users in app data, and let's click on the pencil icon so we can see our work preferences, Peter Hudson, about, image, and yeah, so Bubble will always show us all of the fields attached to a user. He doesn't belong to a company, and that's therefore nothing needs to be in there. All right, guys, really happy with that lesson. Good place to stop, and I'll see you in the next one.